हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड सेफ। आई विल बी टेकिंग योर मैथ्स नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर, प्लेस वैल्यू। नाउ सपोज इफ आई आस्क यू वेयर यू आर लिविंग, सो यू विल टेल आई एम लिविंग इन जामनगर। सो जामनगर इज द प्लेस वेयर यू आर लिविंग, राइट? सेम वे इवन द नंबर्स हैव their particular place, and accordingly we will read and write them. So that is called the place value, where we are placing the number. What is the place of that particular number or particular value of that number? That is place value. In place value, how many digits we have generally? So we have the digits from 0 to 9. So these all are called single digit number, or we can say one digit number. So there are totally 9 digits. And if you see the other digits, like if we say 11, so again it is 1 and 1. 31, 3 and 1. 46, 4 and 6. So we can see here that there are 9 digits in the as the numbers. So the 0 to 9, they are called the digits, and we need to write and or read these numbers. We will use the digits and the place value of that particular number. That means where it is. So that place is the where, that place where the number, particular number is, that gives the value of that number. And generally, where we will use this place value? Whenever we have to write any number or we have to read any number, we will be using this place value. That means the number where it is. Like you are in Jamnagar, same way there should be some place for that digit. So that is called the place value. Now let us see. Here I have drawn 10 blocks. Okay, each is one block, and the same way I have drawn the 10 blocks. So every block is like one, and like that there are 10. So we can call this as 10 ones. That means if you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Clear? So there are 10 blocks, like one block each. So 10 ones. Now if I combine all these blocks, or if I arrange them like this vertically, so again we can have the 10 blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we can write this as 110, because there is one big block that contains this small block. Like if I arrange all these blocks like this, one on another, so we can see there are 10 blocks. And all the 10 blocks are combined to make one big block. So we can see one big block, right? Same way, this can be written as 110, or we can say as 10, right? Now same way, here I am having every block made up of 10 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Like that, I have 10 blocks. Here in every block I have 10 blocks, and the same way I have 10 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right? Now if I have arranged all these 10 blocks, so we will get this design or pattern. Right? So we can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So one more is required. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Here also one more is required. So 10. This side 10, this side 10. So total we will get 100. So this can be written as 10 tens. Here we have 10. Here we have 10. So 10 number of tens. Clear? 10 number of tens. These all are 10 blocks, and like that we have 10 blocks. So 10 number of tens. So this is 10 tens. Now if we combined all these blocks, then we will get here total 100. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now 10 and 10, both sides means if we combine, we will get 100. That means 10 tens is equal to 100. 10 ones is equal to 10. In simple, if we see multiplication, you have learned multiplication, 10 ones, 10 into 1, that is equal to 10. Same way, 10 into tens, that means 10 into 10, that is equal to 100. So 100. Clear? So this is how we will represent the numbers as a place value, in their place value. Now let us see how to read the numbers. Now if we say the highest waterfall, what is the length of the highest waterfall? This waterfall is there in Meghalaya. So the highest waterfall is 335 meter. So generally we say 335, but when we have to specifically tell the place value of the digits, we will read this as, you can see here, this is 1's place, this is 10's place, and this is 100's place. Correct? Now, how can we read this? We can read this as 335. 335. Clear? So we will write this. How can we expand this? Let us see the expanded form. 335. That means 300. What is the place value? It is in the hundreds place. So the first 3 is in hundreds place. So we can write as 300. That means 300. Tens place, again 3. So tens place means 30. Like I told you, 1 tens, 1 into 10, 2 tens, 2 into 10, like 3 tens, 3 into 10. So 30. 5 ones, 5 into 1. So whenever we calculate the place value, simply we will multiply the value with the number, the place where it is. Clear? So 3 is in hundreds place, so 3 into 100, 3 again in tens place, 3 into 10, 5 in ones place, 5 into 10. Right? So we can write this as 300, or if you want more to expand, we can write 3 into 100 plus 3 into 10 plus 5 into 1. Right? So this is how we can write in expanded form. So this is the expanded form. The second one comes is in words. This is in numbers, and how can we write in words? 335. Clear? So we can write this as 335. So every number can be expressed in two forms. One is in expanded form, in word form, and this is in the standard form. Clear? So every number will have can be written in a standard form, in an expanded form, and in the form of number names. So this is the number names and this is the expanded form. Expanded form means whenever we are writing along with the value of that particular place. So this is called place value, right? Now let us take some more examples. There is a world famous dam, or we can say in India, it is the largest dam at the height of 260 meters. So the Tehri Dam in Uttarakhand, it is the height of 260 meter. Now how can we express this as place value and in standard form and in expanded form or in words? This is ones, this is tens, this is hundreds. Now 260, right? Now how can we write this in expanded form? The value 2, so place value is in hundreds place, 2 is in hundreds place, so 2 into 100 plus 6 is in tens place, 6 into 10 plus 0 is in ones place, 0 into 1, right? Now 2 into 100 is 200, 6 into 10 is 60 plus any number when we multiply it with 0, it will be a 0. So this can be written as 200. This is the expanded form, 200 plus 60 plus 0. Now how can we express this in words? 260. You know all the number names, you have already learned in second standard. So this can be written as 260, right? So we can see 60 and there is no ones place. So we can sure that there is 0 in the ones place. So 260, right? So 2 in hundreds place, 6 in tens place, 0 in ones place. So 2 into 100 plus 6 into 10 plus 0 into 1. So that is called 260, right? Now let us take one more example. There are 531 wildlife sanctuaries in India. Wildlife sanctuaries. Now how can we represent this in expanded form and in words? Now we will write this. So there are 3 digits. So children, by seeing the number of digits, we can easily tell how many places will be there. For example, if only one digit will be there, then we can say it is a single digit number. If there are 2 digits, then obviously one will be in ones place and one will be in tens place. If there are 3 digits, so the third one is hundreds place. So just by saying the number of digits, we can tell how many places will be there. So we have ones, tens and hundreds. So 531, right? Now we will write this in expanded form. Now 5 into 100 plus 3 into 10 plus 1 into 1, that is equal to 500 plus 30 plus 1. So this is the expanded form, right? Now how can we write in words? So we know 500 30 plus 1 is 31, right? So this is how we can represent any number in expanded form and in words. So whenever we are writing in expanded form, actually we are writing the place value, we are showing the place value, we are describing the place value of that particular number. Now let us see some more numbers to play. Let us play with some more numbers in our next class. Till then, bye. Keep learning. You can try some more words. Just write down their expanded form in words also and keep learning. Thank you.